the whole question of the IGP going, staying, has become a hot topic among all police officers and the members of the public. The China press over the weekend had come up with a front page story that the IGP will resign, has submitted his letter of resignation to take effect from Police Day, 25th of March, to open a new page for police in Malaysia. To demonstrate that the police are efficient, independent, professional, world-class, which had been denied. And arising from this, the minister has also issued a directive, show cause, to China Press, what action should be taken. I think this is a matter of great concern. The IGP, whether he's going to continue, whether his contract will be extended after September, has been a grave issue among all concerned about the role of police. In fact, there's been talk that the IGP is saying that his contract is 1+1. That means 1 year plus one extra year after September this year. So there's been a lot of question. What is the position? Because there was a parliamentary roundtable last July where all MPs from Pakatan Rakyat rejected the extension of Tan Sri Musa as the IGP. And I said very clearly that if 2,000 top police officers are polled as to whether they want a new IGP, I'm sure the overwhelming majority will want a new IGP. So I think this is an issue which, now that we have this motion, where the whole minister moves a motion, directing in the name of the Dewan, directing the IGP to keep all the roads open. It is based on the concept of a doctrine of separation of powers, that the police is an independent, a credible, professional organization, which is not subject to the Home Minister. And that's why the Home Minister has to come to the Parliament to move a motion to get parliamentary sanction to direct the police to keep the ways open. If at present the IGP is under the thumb of the minister, he knows who is going to be the new IGP. I mean, this makes nonsense of this motion. That's why there's a need for a debate. And in this connection, I would like to ask, what is so great? What is the great deal? What is so big a deal about the China press report? It's a mistake, yes. All right, it's a mistake. It should have been September. He said it's going to be March 25th. But what is so big a deal that show cause has been issued to China Press? I understand that the chief editor-in-chief will have to quit, or there will be a 3-month or 6-month suspension of China Press. What is a big deal? Other countries, there are reports about presidents, prime ministers going to resign, not through correction. And then, of course, their credibility suffers.
Yang kami gunakan ini adalah mengikut peraturan-peraturan yang telah ditetapkan oleh Parlimen. Standing order-nya, usulnya yang telah kita sedia maklum, dan kami sepatutnya diberikan hak untuk membahaskan usul ini kerana ianya ada kepentingan ramai, ada kepentingan rakyat yang telah pun dititahkan oleh Tuan Ku semalam. Jadi apabila dihalang peranan kami untuk membawa suara rakyat dalam konteks membahaskan usul ini, kita melihat ini satu tindakan untuk melarikan diri daripada isu sebenar, untuk mereka mungkin bimbang, pendedahan demi pendedahan yang bakal kita lakukan terhadap apa yang telah dibangkitkan oleh Yang Berhormat siang sebentar tadi tentang ketidakwibawaan IGP untuk melangsungkan tugasnya sebagai Ketua Polis Negara.
Jari. Isu di depan kita ialah soal bagaimana usul dibawa ke Parlimen. Bila usul dibawa ke Parlimen, kita mengharapkan usul ini dibahas. Dan dalam peraturan jelas kita boleh bahas. Yang kita minta ialah, okey, bagi BN 3 orang, kita 3 orang. Kita cakap apa yang rakyat nak dengar. Kemudian kalau dia rasa tak betul, BN boleh ceritakan sebalik, jawablah. Jadi akhirnya rakyat dan juga media-media boleh buat pertimbangan. Kalau ini pun tak boleh dicakap dan dibahas dalam parlimen, di mana lagi kita nak cakap? Kalau rakyat cakap di luar, ISA salah. Kalau cakap dalam ceramah, itu fitnah. Cakap dalam parlimen lah. Tapi kalau ini pun tidak boleh, saya tak nampak di mana lagi kita nak cakap. Dan isu ini isu yang besar, cukup besar. Ia bukan saja melibatkan pentadbiran. Isunya ialah seorang yang menjawab jawatan Ketua Polis Negara. Kita nak bincang, kita nak tanya. Dan kalau you kata betul, betul. Kalau you tak kata betul, jawablah tak betul. Dan akhirnya, kenapa harus punish newspaper? Media salah kod kononnya berbagai-bagai. Jadi inilah tempat medan yang paling bebas, yang termaktub dalam perlembagaan. Cakap.
Pengumuman mengenai pelanjutan seorang penjawat awam selalunya dibuat awal 3 bulan, 4 bulan macam KSN baru ni. Patutnya pension bulan 6 ya.
Yeah.
Disambung 3 bulan. Notis tu supaya menimbulkan kestabilan. Ya, bagi penama tersebut KSN untuk berkhidmat dan orang lain menaruh keyakinan.
Transisi.
Tapi semalam diumumkan bahawa dia akan berhenti dah. Walaupun tarikhnya 6 bulan
September,
lagi.
September.
Jadi dia jadi lame duck. Yeah, dia dah tak stable lagi. Dia dah tidak mungkin tidak berminat.
Spekulasi,
dan
ya.
Usul ini pula menetapkan dia sebagai Ketua Polis Negara mengambil urusan menjaga ini. Betul. Tapi kita nak bahaskan bagaimana kedudukan dia. Saya rasa valid permohonan kita untuk berbahas atas isu ini. Dan tak wajar kalau kita dihalang.